Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Neha Hamilton and I am working as assistant professor in International School of Business Management, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. And today we have taken up a very specific topic which is very much in trend nowadays. So we are going to understand the meaning and definition of innovation and creativity and how to bring out innovation and creativity in your own personality. I mean, what are the things that you can do in your day-to-day life so that you can become innovative and creativity? So innovation and creativity is something which is very important, and this is the only thing that makes you different from others. After 4 years of time, when you will complete your degrees, you will complete your graduation, you will join companies, or you will open up your own company, then the only thing that is going to differentiate you from others is how innovative you are and how creative you are. So a small point of advice that I want to give at the beginning of this lecture is, whenever you are attending any class, it can be subject of any class, just try to think and imagine that particular thing in your own way. Try to bring out something different from that topic. Try to make a picture and try to vision that particular topic from your own way, in your own version, and customize that thing according to you, right? It is not always necessary to, you know, absorb everything in the way your teacher teaches you. But after taking the lecture, do a research on that particular topic. Read on the contemporary news about that particular topic. Whatever you are studying, whatever theory you are studying, there are certain theories that we cannot change, we cannot transform, but yes, you can come out with your version of a particular thing, right? So try to think out of the box, try to think something which is different. What is innovation? Innovation is about looking at your customers and seeing things from their viewpoint and not your own, right? So if you are working for a particular company, or if you have your own company, the most important thing is that you have to think from your customer's point of view, because at the end of the day, you are delivering products and services to customers, and customers, they are king for a particular business. So just think of their viewpoint. What is that thing that they want to have? Now do those particular changes in the product design that you are offering. You may have different kind of disciplines that you are going to choose. Some are going to choose mechanical, some are going to choose civil engineering, some are going to choose metallurgy, right? So these are the different disciplines that you are going to choose. But at the end of the day, you have to go for product design. So product design is a discipline in which you can show your maximum amount of innovation and creativity. You can come up with the designs that have an appeal to the customers also, and your company also is going to like you. So the people who are product designers, they have a lot of creative liberty that is being given by the company. And if you're working for that particular post, then innovation and creativity is something that should be there in your heart and soul. So You have to understand what people want. It is not what makes it easy for you to make, but what makes it easy and smooth for the people to use, right? So I am going to show you a very small video in which we are going to understand that how in a particular product design, you can add some small features of creativity and innovation, and you can make the products more useful, more innovative, and more creative for the customers. So just give me a moment. I'm going to stop sharing the slide and I am going to share a video with you.
Students of product design make models. I have seen hundreds of portfolios where students have been too quick to use CAD without first testing their ideas to see if they will work. The long-term benefits of making models to quickly identify and solve problems has been proven by product designers over and over again. The rest of my advice is purely opinion. I will deliver this advice with a large nod to Baz Luhrmann. Now, design is a journey. When you begin a project, you should not know what the end destination looks like. Do not be in a rush to get to the final solution. Get lost. Go down many paths and enjoy what you discover. Always go too far and then come back. Research. Know your audience. Walk a mile in their shoes, and if you can't, try to understand all the nuances surrounding who you are designing for and what you are designing. Never stop asking why. Whatever you design, always make it new in some way. The brief is king. Challenge it, exceed it, but you must answer it. CAD is only one tool. Currently, it cannot tell you how something feels or behaves in your hand, or how heavy or uncomfortable it is in use. A pretty picture of a design is not a product. Take things apart. You cannot hope to improve anything if you don't know how it works. If you take a found object and put a light bulb in it, you are just upcycling. People say you are only as good as your last project. Rubbish. You are only as good as your next project because of everything you have learnt. Make lots of mistakes and learn from them. No real good has come from forcing anything. Take regular breaks and never think that will do. Don't design to make money. Design because you care. And trust me about making models.
Right. So we have seen an exceptional video that made us understand that why innovation and creativity is something which is very important, especially a technical student to have in their personality. Why it is important to be innovative, to bring out that innovation and creativity in whatever you make. We have learned a lot of things from this small 2-minute video that research is very important. So whenever you think of developing a particular kind of product design, research is something which is very important. What has happened before? What can happen in future? What are the possibilities of a particular thing or a particular product design that you have to identify and that you have to work on, right? And you have to work on a particular thing continuously. You do not have to lose hope if you're not coming up with a good product. The next thing that we have understood is that CAD, which is computer aided design, is just an application software that gives you an idea of how you can design. The physical parameters can be understood by that particular software, but that software is not going to help you that how physically that particular product feels, whether it is comfortable or not, whether it is usable or not, whether it is user friendly or not. These are things you are not going to understand from CAD, right? So CAD is just a starting point. Don't use it or over rely it. Through CAD, you can design products, you can give shape to the products. But at the end time, you have to make certain changes according to your particular need, according to particular user need, right? So research is important. And anything, if your goal and your motive should be clear and genuine. If you are working for money, if you want to earn money, that should always be the secondary motive. Your primary motive should be to make the life of mankind much easier, to make people happy, to offer them those kind of products that with the help of which they can excel in their life, they can make their life easier, right? So if your goal and your focus is genuine, it is clear, And if you are good from your heart and you are doing this kind of innovation and productivity, then definitely it is going to work. And at the end of the day, money is going to follow, right? So the primary motive should not be money, but the primary motive should be to bring something good for the people, to bring something productive for the people. This should be the primary motive. Now let's move forward. What is creativity? Creativity implies creating new stuff by combining two or more existing ideas. So where innovation is all about creating something new which is not existing in the nature before, creativity is, you know, combining two or three ideas which are already present and come up with a new thing which is very new and exceptionally powerful. So that is called as creativity. So creativity is a word which is somewhere can be used in design, it can somewhere be used in art forms, or it can somewhere be used in the things where, you know, you can show your vision, your ideology, your philosophy through colors, through drawings, through designs and all those things. So this is where creativity comes into play, where innovation can be linked to invention. Creativity can be linked to something which is artistic, which provides a different kind of shape to your product, which provides more usability of your product, more user-friendly a product is, right? So that is creativity. And whenever you are designing a product for your customers, it has to be a combination of innovation and creativity both. Now, creativity is a generic term. It is abstract and no reference to quality in regards to a specific situation and task. Creativity is not a goal in itself. It is the character of an activity. It is very deep. Character of an activity. It is not a goal, right? It is not what you achieve, but it is how do you achieve it, right? It implies nothing more than an exploration with an intention of creating something new with some kind of value. Telling someone that we are going to have a creative process implies nothing more than we are going to spend some time coming up with something new, but it should be. We are going to come up with something that really works. So doing a work which you do daily, if you do it with some kind of a creativity, you do it differently, that shapes the end product, that improves the end product, that is creativity. If you come up with a new product itself, which is different, which is not existing in the market, that is innovation, right? So innovation and creativity, they are both different, but yes, they go hand in hand. Next thing is a very beautiful saying which says that creativity is not a talent, but creativity is a drive. So creativity is not something, you know, which is inborn. ऐसा नहीं आप पैदा हुए क्रिएटिविटी आप साथ लेकर आए ऐसा नहीं है इट इज अ ड्राइव इट इज अ एनर्जी दैट इज इन यू इफ यू वांट टू बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर्स इफ यू वांट टू डू समथिंग गुड फॉर द सोसाइटी इफ यू वांट टू शो एवरीबडी दैट आई एम वर्थ फॉर दिस सोसाइटी आई एम हियर टू हेल्प आई एम हियर टू डिलीवर देन इट दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग मेक्स यू क्रिएटिव. Being unique has no value in itself until it gives the customer something of value, right? So being unique is of no value, but if that uniqueness provides value to the customers, yes, that is something which can be called as creative, right? If you are making a very ara tera design that is of no meaning to a customer, then it is not creativity. But yes, if you are making some kind of a design which makes it easier for a customer to use a particular product, which improves the usability of a particular product, then yes, that is creativity. Now, again, I am going to show you a very small story. And through this small story, you are going to learn how to become creative. So this is a very interesting story of a kindergarten student who goes to a nursery class. Right? And how through our education system, all the creativity and innovation has been killed. So we are going to understand that what is those things in our education system that should be eliminated to make our students more creative and more innovative.
And this story is written by a woman called Helen Buckley, and I'm going to paraphrase it a little, so allow me that liberty. Once upon a time, there was a little boy, and this little boy was just starting school. He was so excited to go to school, to meet his new teacher, his new friends, and have all these exciting experiences and learn new things. And his very first day at school, one of the first things the teacher said is, "Come on, children, we're going to make a picture." He was so excited, he was thrilled because he loved to draw. And immediately he grabbed those crayons and he started to draw. But the teacher said, "Wait, not yet." She said, "Today we're going to draw pictures of flowers." "That's fine," thought the little boy, because he liked flowers. He could draw all kinds of flowers and all colors, and he thought, "I'm going to draw a field full of flowers." And he started to draw. But the teacher said, "Wait, today we're going to draw a red flower with a green stem." The little boy looked at his picture and frowned a little. He liked his flowers, his full field of flowers. But it's okay, he thought. He turned his paper over and he started to draw a red flower with a green stem. The next day when he went to school, his teacher gave him a ball of Play-Doh. And he was so excited. Play-Doh's fun, he thought. And he started to pull and pinch and make snakes and elephants. But the teacher said, "Wait, today we're going to make bowls with our Play-Doh." "That's fine," thought the little boy, and he started to make a bowl. It was square and it had curves on the edges, but the teacher said, "Wait, we are all going to make a deep round bowl." The little boy looked at his bowl. He liked it much better, but he knew he had to listen to his teacher, and also he smushed all the Play-Doh together and he started to make a round, deep dish. And pretty soon, whatever he did, he learned to wait and to listen and to do things exactly the way his teacher wanted him to. Now, one day, there was a little bit of a change in this little boy's life. He moved cities, and that meant he had to go to a brand new school. And this was a bigger school. And on his very first day there, the teacher said, "Come on, children, let's draw a picture." And everybody started to draw, but the little boy just sat and waited. His new teacher came up to him and said, "What's happening? Are you going to draw a picture?" And he looked at his teacher and he said, "But what shall I draw?" And the teacher said, "Anything you want." And the boy looked at her a little confused. "Anything at all?" "Of course," said the teacher. "Any colors?" he asked. She said, "Sure, any colors. If everyone drew the same thing, how would I know who made what?" The little boy looked at her confused again. Then he looked at his paper and he started to draw. Can you guess what he drew? He drew a red flower with a green stem. So, tell me, what's happening here? What happened to this little boy? What is...
So you have seen this beautiful story. If I ask you, what have you learned from this story? What will you say? What have you learned from this particular story? This story has a very good teaching. So what have you learned? Yes. Anybody? Have you understood the story, all of you? You can either write in the chat box or you can unmute yourself and you can express that what have you understood from this story. Nothing. Okay. Nobody. There are like 14 people in this room and nobody has understood the story. I'm again going to wait for 2 more minutes and then I'm going to explain you what is that thing that we have learned in the story. So Rajat has written something that we have to make our mind as a creative mind. Okay, good, good, Rajat. Good, very good, well said. So the very unfortunate thing that happened with that poor student was then that whenever a task was given to him, this particular task always comes with some sort of instructions. That if you even have to make a drawing, all the specifications are given to you that this drawing should be a flower and that flower should be of red color, of green stem and a green leaf. What if a student wants to draw a flower which instead of 4 petals has 10 petals, which instead of red color is of purple color, which instead of green stem has a brown stem, right? So whenever we give instructions about a particular thing to children, we are actually killing their creativity. So this is one point of advice that I want to tell you, that whenever you attend a lecture, whenever you understand a theory, try to interpret that particular theory in your own version. Try to visualize the usefulness of that particular product in your own mind. Try to change that thing or improvise that particular product design or that particular thing for the customer. If we are producing electric cars, then how it can be more efficient, how it can be more useful for the customers, right? So these are the things that we need to understand and we need to make people understand about these things, right? So what is innovation and creativity? For example, if I tell you, please clap and create the sound of the thunder, what will you do? How will you do that? Who is Sam? Sam Stubridge, please don't message unnecessary in this group. If I'm asking you any question, then only message. Otherwise, please don't message unnecessary. I can read all the messages, right? Please try to concentrate on the class. Okay, so I was talking about creation and innovation. So if I give you a very small task of, you know, clap and create the sound of the thunder. There can be 1,000 ways through which you can clap. You can just pat the table in which you are sitting. You can pat on your legs. You can make sound with your legs. You can make the sound with a combination of your legs and hands. With your mouth, you can make that sound. So there are 1,000 ways through which you can make that sound. The question is how creative you are. If 100 people are sitting in an auditorium and if I tell them to create the sound of the thunder, the question is how many of them are different from others? How many of them think of different ways through which they can create the sound of the thunder? Another thing that we are going to discuss is that why didn't I think of that? So as humans, we always try to escape from situations. We never try to face the challenges that we have in our lives. We always tend to give excuses that I have this thing going on in my life. I have financial crunch, which is going on in my life. So I can't study. I can't concentrate. I can't do. So we have to think beyond these challenges and restrictions that we all face as humans in our life. Everybody in every phase of life face different kind of challenges. But if we keep on making excuses of these challenges and hide away from the challenges that actually are there in front of you, or make excuses, things are never going to be sorted out. So it is very important to keep yourself focused, to think beyond the problems and situations that you have right now in your hand. And for innovation, finance is something which is not important. To generate an idea, life problems are something that are going to reinforce that, that are not going to stop that, but that those are going to reinforce your creativity and your innovation, right? If you face tough conditions in your life, if you face hard times in your life, that makes you more efficient, that makes you more effective, and that brings out the sharpness in the work that you do. If you do not manage the culture manages you. Don't let your environment define your strategy. Don't be the slave of the environmental conditions that you are having. In fact, you use those environmental conditions positively to reinforce yourself, to motivate yourself, to create a product or a design that has a good appeal, right? Why every time IIT and IIM students are coming up with new kind of product designs, new kind of strategies, why they are only forecasting what is going to happen in the third wave of Corona? Why only they are making different kind of sanitizers and masks that are useful? Why not we are making? Because we are not thinking differently as they do. They have the same kind of mind that we have, same kind of circumstances, same kind of resources that we have. The only difference is thinking out of the box, thinking about making the life easier for people, thinking how to make people more happy, how to make their life more easy, right? This is the only difference that a simple student and a IITian have. So please increase the scope of your thinking, think out of the box. Do not only think about your marks, your studies, your family, your financial status, your needs, your beliefs, but try to think of whatever is happening abroad. Try to think on what are the trends which are going to come in future, and what is there which can make you innovate things. We need to rethink how we run our companies and organizations, right? So I have this beautiful article that I'm going to share with you, and these are the 10 brilliant innovations which are done by IIT students. So these are the innovations which are done by very young students just like you, right? And they have done a very beautiful innovation that we are going to study. But before that, let us understand some lessons about innovations that we should learn, how to make ourselves innovative. So the first thing is solve problems for yourself or your loved ones, right? So it is very important to solve small problems that are there in our lives. How with creativity and with innovation we can solve those problems. For example, problem can be a source of opportunity. Solving someone's problems is a well-used path for innovation, right? So basically, it is important to solve a problem and come up with a solution that is helpful for all the people. So let us understand how EDM came into today's world, how it came into existence. So Frank McNamara got the idea to co-found Diners Club credit card in 1950. He once had to pay a restaurant bill but realized he didn't have the cash in his pocket. So this is a real life problem that he has actually seen. What is the name of the person? The name of the person is McNamara, and he was actually sitting in a restaurant in 1950, and he has the money but he do not has the cash to pay the bill of that particular restaurant. So what happened? He realized that he did not have cash in the pocket. In late 1960s, John Adrian Stepard Baron hit upon the idea to create an ATM to solve the problem he faced of being unable to go to the bank during office hours to withdraw cash. So earlier, when the facility of ATM or cash withdrawal or online banking was not there, people were having hard time to pay beyond office hours. You know, at 8 p.m. in the night and 9 p.m. at the night, no bank is open. You cannot go and withdraw cash. right? So from that particular need in 1960s, ATM came into existence where you can take out the cash, you can withdraw the cash at any point of the day, at any point of the time in day. So that is how ATM came into existence. So it came into existence to solve a particular problem which actually Frank McNamara faced. And John Adrian, he came with a solution of ATM which solved the problem of many of us. And nowadays, ATM is so convenient for all of us. And even now, online banking and UPI payment is a revolution in the in financial industry. You know, next is Alfred Bird created egg-free custard for his wife who would get indigestion from egg-based custard. So earlier, if you have heard of custard, which is a dessert which we all used to relish when we were kids, and you know, after dinner, your mom used to make custards. But earlier, it was egg-based custard, you know. But there was a gentleman, and his name was Alfred Bird, and he specifically make a custard which is egg-free, which nobody can think of at that particular time, which was make of corn flour, right? And in India, it is a big hit because most of the people are vegetarians; they do not consume egg, but not consuming egg doesn't mean that you cannot even consume custard. You can consume custard which is made of corn flour, which is very much vegetarian, and you can consume it. So this idea of solving a personal problem, how his wife was having a problem not eating egg, not having the luxury of eating a very delicious dessert which is custard, he created a you know, variant of custard which is actually egg-free. And he only later come up with the idea of a yeast substitute, which is baking powder. So yeast is again a kind of a living bacteria, and some people are allergic to that. It is actually used in making breads. But he came up with a chemical composition which is very similar to yeast and which is baking powder, which do the same kind of thing of putting air and a little fermentation in your dough or your batter. Right, so these are the very small inventions which have actually changed our life. This invention of baking powder has changed the face of baking industry, which was earlier not possible without egg. But nowadays, without egg, there are bakeries which are specially, you know, egg-free bakeries, completely egg-free products they make only because of the help of this invention. So this invention has not only benefited the mankind and the people who were facing problems, but it has enhanced a new industry, baking industry, which is called as eggless baking industry. Another important example is Will King solved his razor burn problem by combining shaving foam with his wife's baby oil to create King of Shaves gel. He managed to get it listed in Harrods and then at Boots, and the gel is now the third largest shaving brand in the UK. So earlier people were using this kind of a shaving cream which was causing a lot of itchiness and a lot of irritation on their skin, but he has come up with a new formula where he has just, you know, randomly combined his shaving cream with a baby oil that his wife or his kids were using. He combined it and he used it on his face, and it was a big success. This shaving gel is the third largest shaving brand in UK, and it is doing a great business. So very small problem and a very, very simple solution. You know, just thinking out of the box. Nobody will think that a shaving cream and a baby oil can be combined. Nobody can think on that. And even at that particular point of time, people may laugh at that. You know, how can this happen? How can this happen? But when it actually happened, it changed the lives of many people and it changed the industry. It has created a new business at a particular point of time. Will Shu was frustrated at not being able to get quality food delivered at the restaurant. So we have Swiggy in India, we have Zomato in India, we have Food Panda in India. But do you know when it was started? It was started in 2013, right? It was started in 2013, where a person who was facing a problem, his name was Will Shu, and he was actually frustrated because, you know, he was loving the food in the restaurant, but the delivery time was so much, the delivery charges were so much that he was not able to, you know, make food available at his particular home. So what he did, he founded Deliveroo in 2013 to fill this gap. And it was a small startup which is now worth $2 billion and which operates in 84 cities in different countries all across the India. And Swiggy, Zomato, Foodpanda is just a copy of that app, which was originally started in USA, right? In UK, started in London, right? So this is how inventions are being made out of a problem that you want to solve. That problem can be very small problem, and that small problem can have a very simple solution. You just have to think how to solve this particular problem, and you never know how that particular thing can, you know, become big, can change the face of an industry, can change the face of a particular product which is available in the market nowadays. Another thing that we are going to understand is, how do you take inspiration from the culture? So travel is something that can change, travel and, observing other nations' culture, going to different places, seeing different things can also inspire you to do certain changes to come up with creation and innovation, right? So the people who are authors, who write novels, who write creative content, the people who are artists, who are drawing, who paint, these all people, they try to change their surroundings in order to bring out that creativity and innovation in their minds. This is what you as engineers can also do, right? So we have some live examples that shows us that how innovation and creativity has shaped the culture, has shaped a particular product. Travel and exposure to global culture are a great source of inspiration. Cultural products like sci-fi movies can also inspire visions and prototypes. For future applications of technology, Michael Cooper of Motorola get the inspiration for the handheld mobile phones while watching Star Trek. The first public phone call was made in 1973. So this was a person from Motorola. His name was Richard Michael Cooper, and he saw people standing on a phone booth in the middle of a market and talking to people. So at that particular time, he came up with the idea that how about, not making this mobile phone stationary at a particular thing, and how about making the phones mobile? People can take with them anywhere they go. And that's how, when in 1973, the concept of mobile phone was launched. And nowadays, you can see that everybody has a mobile phone, and we cannot imagine our lives without mobile phones. So this is the status of mobile phones, and this is the status of that invention that was made in 1973. A very simple thought. What was that simple thought? That instead of making it stationary, why can't I make it mobile? I mean, why people have to go to a certain location and call to a people? Why they cannot keep in their pocket, right? And call whenever they call like and they feel like, and call to anybody at any point of the day. So this is when mobile phone was discovered. Another important thing is, Glenn Bell got the idea for his Taco Bell chain by noticing the popularity of tacos at a Mexican restaurant in California. He created a fast food version by frying the taco shells in advance, and the chain was sold to PepsiCo for $125 million in 1978. So Glenn Bell was actually a person who was traveling to Mexico, and he saw that people like people like the Taco Bell, the tacos so much, right? So he created a chain of Taco Bell throughout the countries where, you know, which has a valuation worth in billions. And it is a very successful chain, and he got that inspiration from Mexico, because in people in Mexican, they generally like tacos, right? So he just created a very small chain. He deep fried that taco, and he filled all that fillings, cheese and vegetables and all that, and he was selling it. So this was just a very small idea that changed his destiny, that changed the fast food industry. So you know, we have McDonald's, we have Burger King, and we have also Taco Bell. The next thing that we are going to understand is that what are the things that can bring out innovation in a corporate or in a company? When you work in a company, because eventually you have to work in a corporate or you have to work in a company whenever you will, you know, join or complete your degree. So innovation starts at the top. So the first thing is that innovation should always come from the leaders of the organization. They should always inspire people to bring out innovations in them. Next is the best way to kill creativity in a team is letting the boss speak first. So I have shown you a story where, you know, when you already are with a set of instructions and you have to make a product, you can do nothing new in that particular product. But if you just have an idea and from that idea you have to develop a particular product, that actually becomes very easy to develop a new product or something which is new. When you use your own mind, when you think out of the box, new kind of things are going to come in the market, which is going to benefit people. Next thing is research and development. Innovation can happen anywhere. Anyone can do it, but not everyone is good in it. So, you know, research and development is very important if you are looking for a change in an existing product or if you want to do change in a particular product. So research and development is very important. You read the articles which are based on a particular thing. You ask people, you ask your teachers, you ask your seniors, you do your research, and then you work on the particular idea that you have. You will get an idea that whether that can be functional or not, that can be actually practical or not. Next is innovation is a team sport. Operating inside silos is deadly. So collaborate. Silos means it is like a compact container, right, where we used to store something. So, you know, whatever idea you have, you need to share with the people whom you trust, your team, your colleagues, the people who are senior to you in the company, so that the idea can be given wings and the idea can actually be implemented with their help. Innovation is never easy, but it is always possible. Step by step, project by project, small ideas need room and time to grow. We need to see what we make progress. So it is not that in one day or 2 days of time we are going to come up with the innovation, but it takes time, it takes courage, it takes research, it takes a lot of processes to come up with a new product. The next thing is, just because it works for Google doesn't mean it will work for you. Create an innovation culture that fits, right? So Google has created an office. If you read about the articles of Google offices, you will get to know that the office which is created by Google is a luxurious office where you can play polo, you can take a nap, there are sleeping pods, there is a restaurant, there is a gym, there is a fun center, there is a recreation center. But what will happen if we create this kind of office in India? The mentality of Indians are totally different, right? So that kind of office is not going to work in India. If we give this much of liberty to people, they are not going to work. So it depends on culture to culture. Just copying a concept from one country and applying that on your country will not work. You have to do the changes as per the requirements. You have to fit that particular thing in the culture of that particular company. So I'm again going to share a video that is going to show you some innovations that every student should watch, right? These are some innovations which are mostly done by students. So I'm going to stop sharing the slide. I'm going to start.
many secrets do you carry around every day? Your wallet, your phone, and some little secret. Oh, no, not that. This secret. Besides the ones that need to be put in the safe, you must have some secrets you write down that require proper protection. Introducing Lockbook, the world's first writing notebook with a biometric fingerprint sensor. Lockbook comes with a 0.40 inch by 0.55 inch fingerprint sensor with 508 dpi resolution. The biometric fingerprint sensor allows Lockbook to recognize your fingerprint and unlock within 1 second. When it is locked, no one can even try to take a peek. You can bring it wherever you want to. Your office, conference room, client's office, or anywhere else. For an innovative notebook, the product design is also top-notch. To provide you with a better writing experience, we chose the top-quality paper for the pages inside, possibly the best in the world. For long-term convenience, we use the binder design and provide you with different accessories, like refill paper, a hole puncher, pocket folders, sticky notes, etc. Be as creative as you want to design your own notebook. Now we need your help to deliver Lockbook to you.
Did you know that 65% of people around the world are visual thinkers? People who love to write and sketch and make notes. We seek the simplest possible way to plan our lives, but haven't figured out how to put events from our paper planners into digital calendars. While searching for the best visual way to plan, we chose the circular diagram because it looks like a clock face and it takes less effort to focus on what's going to happen and when it's going to happen. So we designed the Slice Planner, the undated handcrafted paper planner made from all natural materials and premium Swedish paper, and developed an app that merges paper events with your favorite digital calendars. How would you like a paper planner that enables reminders, invites, and locations synced on all your devices? That's what the app does. It's easy to use, and it's powered by Google Cloud Vision for optical character recognition. Like that. Even if someone just scheduled a meeting in your digital calendar, but you don't want to merge your events from physical planner into it, we've got you covered. Our app has an augmented reality mode that shows whether you have any conflicts and events so that you can resolve them. After all, there's only one you. We can't be in two places at once. We know you love to make notes, sketches, or mind maps covering the whole page with markings. Slice Planner lets you sort what data to save simply by drawing a line around it of any shape, on any surface. If you want to quick share your ideas, just mark the corresponding icon below. Alternatively, you can share a slice or attach a whole page to an all-day event. Whether used as a standalone planner with various designs or together with our app, Slice Planner will provide flexibility that wasn't there before.
Thank you. For thousands of years, human beings have taken notes in the same way, by writing down. But focusing on writing down means that you easily miss the action. Now, there is finally a much better way to make sure you never fall behind. Introducing Titan Note, a small, portable recording device that automatically turns what's being said into text. This way, for your next lecture, class, meeting, or discussion, you can be fully focused and not have to worry about writing everything down. Titan Note accurately does that for you. Why go through the hassle and stress of writing everything down when Titan Note does it automatically for you? Once you use Titan Note.
Right, so we can go on and on. There are lots of discoveries and innovation that I wanted to show you, but we have some time constraints, so I cannot show you that full video. So we actually have a lot of innovations that have come out of the problems that we face in our day-to-day lives. That idea of the pen was awesome. The idea of creating a notebook, a diary, planner that you can link through an app with your laptop and your phone is very exceptional. A small recording device that you can also use in your lectures, you know, you just have to record the lecture and that will automatically convert that speech into notes. So you have lots of devices that are there to make your life easy and simpler, right? So these are the things that you need to, I have given you these examples because I wanted to show you that how with small needs and small problems that we face in our daily lives, we can deal with a lot of problems with coming up with these innovations, inventions and creativity, right? So I think that's enough for today. We have covered a lot of things today. We have covered how to bring out the creativity in your personality, how to be innovative. We have learned a lot of things that people have come up with. We have understood that the famous inventions like ATM and, you know, shaving gel, which are very small things in our life, but how people have seen the problem and how people have come up with a new innovation and a new product that has made our life easier and simpler. Right? So I think that's it for today. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much for listening patiently. I am officially ending the meeting now.
কি নাম ছিল এর? সাহিল। হ্যালো হ্যালো সাহিল, হ্যালো সাহিল,